Nou, this is even the 15th edition. Man, I'm getting so old. You guys keep getting younger, so. That's good. So we started in 2002, making Blender open source, and since then, every year in October, we had the Blender conference. And I think already for the 7th time in the Bali, which is the best venue ever. It's very cozy, very cool, but it's getting a bit small. We already had these top-selling tickets last month. So I will find and try to find solutions for that next year. But for this year, we will still all enjoy the Bali tremendously. So I usually start with a little warming up to give everybody the opportunity to say something or to put up your arms and stuff like that. For example, I want to know where are people coming from. I want to see Dutch hands. How many Dutch hands do we have here? Okay, the Netherlands. Yeah, that's quite nice. And then our neighbor countries, here, Germany. There's many more. Okay, there are more Germans anyway. Belgium. We have a couple of Belgians. Ah, they're all sitting together. And France, come on, La France. Okay, hey, the Brits. Where are the Brits? Cool. So now we go a little bit to the south, Spain, of course, we have lots of Spanish people. Wow. Italians, where are the Italians? Okay, a little bit more. Portuguese, maybe? Then we go a little bit further, Greece. I heard there's at least one, and there's another Greek in the other place, I know. So, Nordic countries, everything above Denmark and going up and stuff. Nice. Russians. Where are the Russians? There are Russians. There's also another. Ah, there's a Russian. Awesome. Cool. Poland, of course. Not forget Poland. Sorry. So now I'm forgetting all the countries in Europe, of course. So let's see the, who is the Eastern Europe, like Hungary or. What? Ah. Cool. So. And maybe Iceland or so. We haven't had it all. Any country I missed? So let's go to the other side of the Atlantic. So America. So many people are from the Americas, both continents. Ah, okay, that's cool. Costa Rica, I know that, USA. Central America, there. Okay, good. Then we have Australia. There must be at least, whoa, 3, 4, 5. Wow, that's awesome. And the whole Asian thing, like starting with Turkey to Japan.
India.
India, awesome. Good. And then we have Africa, of course. Africa. That's fun. Is that Greg? Yeah, hi, welcome. So, I think I had, did I miss anyone? Good. So next one, what are you guys using Blender for? So I first want to see coders getting their hands up. Who's coding here? Coders. Look at those people, right? They are here for 3 days, and they will listen to the artists and users, and you can ask them anything, really anything. They will do it, I'm sure. So who's using Blender for? Of course, modeling, of course, everybody, right? Modeling, mostly modeling. Or are you doing visual effects for film or for TV, visual effects, cool. Or are you doing more scientific stuff, visualization, science, and that kind of thing? Ah. Or architecture, architects. Ah, that's also cool. Animation, character animation. Ah, that's so cool. I love character animation. Or games, of course. Game, what? So, come on, games. Game design, or using the Blender Game Engine. Who uses Blender Game Engine? Aha, keep talking about it. It's important too. So, did I miss something?
Education, video editing.
Video editing, the sequencer, of course. That's the best part of Blender. So, what are people here make a daily living using Blender? Who is that? Let me show. That's so cool. Yeah, fantastic. And are you doing that, for example, as a teacher, teaching? Yeah? Or as a freelancer or entrepreneur, working on art and that kind of thing? Yeah. That's fantastic. Or how many scientists are you working for universities with Blender stuff? This one. Yeah? Probably in the other room a lot. There's usually always many of them. So, on the last one, for who is this the first conference? The first? Good, you will have so much fun. And we're going to do a countdown very quick. The second conference, who is coming back? Or the three, who did three conferences? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 or more. 10 or more. How many is that? Okay. Okay, who did? Well, there's also a very special people who did 15 conferences. Can I see the 15 conference people? This one and this one. And me. Good. So, next. So, I want to start the conference with a word of a message for you guys, a theme for the conference. And I thought about this. So people who know me, sometimes in the studio, I try to be polite online in the emails, and then I run away from my desk. Idiots, what idiots? Why are people so stupid always? Why don't they know how to do, and then fill in whatever, coding or design, or maybe interface, thinking about things, because I like quality, I like innovation, I like to do things a little bit out of the box, not copying everything, but doing something like, if everybody does it, exactly. So how can we get that thing in Blender improved? How do we handle that as an open source community? So I was been looking around for some wise advice. So let's see, for example, what has Steve Jobs to say about this?
I didn't know how to explain it then, but I've thought a lot about it since. If you, most things in life, the dynamic range between average and the best is at most 2-to-1. Right? Like if you go to New York City and you're getting an average taxi cab driver versus the best taxi cab driver, you know, you're probably going to get to your destination with the best taxi cab maybe 30% faster. You know, in an automobile, what's the difference between an average and the best? Maybe, I don't know, 20%? The best CD player and an average CD player, I don't know, 20%? So 2-to-1 is a big, big dynamic range in most of life. In software, and it used to be the case in hardware too, the difference between average and the best is 50-to-1, maybe 100-to-1.
Easy.
Okay? Yeah. Very few things in life are like this, but what I was lucky enough to spend my life in is like this. And so I've built a lot of my success off finding these truly gifted people and not settling for B and C players. But
so, Steve. I mean, he's a great guy, but on this specific thing, I don't think I agree with him. And especially not, this is not a message we want to have for an open source community. Right? There is something different here going on. So let's listen to another wise person, which is a Brazilian entrepreneur, Ricardo Semler. Many people might not have heard of him, but he's a genius. He's well known for starting companies in a way that reflects communities, and he's tremendously successful. Listen what he has to say.
That the tribes have always said the following. Now, wait a second. Now, if I'm going to have an organization, I need to have the smartest, the best, the most intelligent. And that's how it was, looking for the very smart investment bankers, the very smartest people in advertising in the 60s, 70s, the very smartest people in the technology age. But What that does is it makes an intelligent case of let me find only the very best, but it ignores wisdom. And it ignores anthropology by saying that we will only be able to work and our organization will only survive if it has a crosscut of humanity. And so if 2% of the world, of the population, is lazy, we need 2% of lazy in every company. If 2% are thieves and are going to steal something from the company, we need 2% of thieves. If we don't follow that distribution of what humanity looks like, we're going to end up with an organization that is outside its own medium. It is something that doesn't reflect the rest, and you think that in that bubble you're able to produce. And I'm sure you are for a short period of time.
So yeah, the bubble. We don't want to be in a bubble. And the Blender project and the success of Blender and the whole Blender community reflects this. Even though I can be highly annoyed sometimes, they're all part of the family. That includes the trolls on the forums, that includes all the newbies who come in and claim that they can make fantastic code or they're the best artist in the world. They are all part of this. And I think that that whole thing together is what makes Blender strong. That's good. But how then do you make sure that we do have what we want, which is also a little bit of good quality software development, or good websites and documentation? Now there's another one here I want to introduce. He's also famous. Not many people will know him, Joel on Software. He's a wise man. He writes about coding and coders and managing, which is fantastic. And recently, he sent a newsletter with a number of articles about how to get good people on board, and also how do you handle this. You have to make them instead of stealing them, that's one thing. And they introduced a term I hadn't heard before. It's called onboarding. I understand the concept, but I didn't know the word. And onboarding is interesting. Onboarding means that you have your organization ready for new people to come on board. That's not only for companies interesting, but especially for open source. And here, a thing we've recently found ourselves, but we are burning out our seniors and our most experienced developers too much. Because the highest qualified people with the most experience are also doing all the stupid jobs, the silly jobs, the reviews, the bug fixes and stuff. Because they're really good at it, I know. But you can do it in a different way. You can instead spread it with juniors, the new people they can help. So that's one of the things I would like to define as a goal for 2017. I want to set up onboarding and make sure that we relieve our experienced developers from all the bug trackers and reviewing and all that kind of things, except in their area. But we can involve new people for it. There's a lot of new developers who already came on board in the past years, and we have to trust them more. We have to empower them to also help to get more people on board. The Development Fund and the donations are going to help with that. So, we also did lots of stuff in the past year. Got a bit of water. But I'm not going to go over all of this. We have a whole Blender conference to look at all the progress and all the fantastic things we have been doing. But I want to focus on one thing. Here, the thing that is hanging in the sky somewhere. The mythical project. It will never happen. It's too complicated, right? It's too much, too big, it's everything. I know. But I like that ambition. I like to make sure that we can do this. But there's a number of challenges for it. For example, we have the increasing quality demands. Lots of professional users, studios, people are making film with Blender. It's the complexity of the software is increasing. You know, if you can code something in the beginning, in a weekend, and then the second version will take a small team several months. And if you then want to make a better version, you suddenly become Facebook with 10,000 employees to make a website, right? So that complexity thing in software is normal. You can't make something better unless you have exponentially more people working on things. So we have to get more full-timers. And people say you can do crowdfunding or you can put more pressure on the community. But I think the community is already doing fantastic. They support us. They support us with the development fund and the cloud, but they also support Blender Market and Cookie and Guru. And a lot of people are making an ecosystem of making money with Blender, with the community. That's good, and that might grow, but that's not sufficient. So what I wanted to do is to talk to the stakeholders, the studios, and the industry. I say, guys, we want you, and you have to support Blender as well. So yeah, so I have to go after business. And that was my focus for the past 5-6 months. And I've got a number of very nice results to report. First, on board was Nimble Collective. Yoo-hoo! They are heavily investing in Blender themselves. The Extreme Works artists using Blender to make film. You can see a little bit more about that later. But they also support Blender Institute to make development happen. At depth graph, pipeline topics, important parts of the Blender 2.8 project. Another one on board is Tangent Animation. This is even bigger. This is a studio, and they're growing to 120-something people, making a second feature film with Blender already. They did Run As You Run, which will get a sneak little preview tonight at the festival. And they will have a talk, I think, tomorrow about the pipeline and things. This is going to be awesome. But because of their investment in Blender already, they hired Blender developers, Cycles coders and stuff for their own studio. And they support 2 Blender developers to work with us in Amsterdam to work on the viewport, especially. That's Dalai Valinto and Clement Foucault. They're coming on board, and they will make a fantastic viewport system together, of course, with Mike Irwin and other developers. That's not all. We've got AMD on board. So, AMD, same story, 2 developers. One is for the viewport, make sure that Blender OpenCL gets upgraded to the latest version, and especially to get it ready for Vulkan. Vulkan might come in next 2 years or so, will become more industry standard. And it's a fantastic system for high quality rendering in real time. And Blender should be ready for that. That's what Mike Irwin is working on. And the new developer, Mai, and she's working on Cycles currently. She did displacement, micro displacement, and she's now making sure Blender will also work in OpenCL at the same quality level as CPU and CUDA. So, and that's not all. Of course, we also have the Blender Cloud and the Blender Institute. So, the cloud supporters and some of the other business we do in the Institute, they pay for me, and they pay for Sergei, they pay for Sibren. We do project coordination of the whole thing, and of course, depth graph and pipeline development. But is that all? Now we've got even more. Yesterday, I closed a deal with Aleph Objects from the Lowspot printers, and they're going to add 2 more developers to work on the workflow and the Blender 101 project. So that means that the 101 project is a test or a prototype, to call it, but it's meant to be a easy-to-use, kids-friendly for education version of Blender that is stripped down 99% to something which is easy to configure and to put in classrooms, or to make a 3D print, or do something simple. But it is release compatible. That means that if people say, I like that 101 thing, it's easy to use, you can also expand it. And then if you want to, you can have the full Blender and the whole power of this open source project. Mike Pan has been involved as a quartermaster, we call it. He's getting ready for things, getting the designs, making a good proposal. And if the proposal is fine, Aleph Objects will support 2 people at least for 1 year. To make sure that we have Blender workflow configuring work and 101. Fantastic. So, summarizing, this is what I got in the past 4 or 5 months. This is 10 new full-time Blender developers of things. So I think we can say we are there, we're getting there. So the first Blender 2.8 alpha, beta, something, I think we can have that already this summer. And that will have new viewport, real-time PBR, will have UI and workflow configurations in the first version, there will be cycles improvements, Sergey will be working on duplicators, overrides, caching, and pipeline goodies. The only thing that's on hold is our ambition to do the Everything Node project, to get physics and particles and modifiers and object updates and constraints and whatever, and a beautiful big new system. I think that was one step too far. You can't have one person do this by himself. You need a team for that. So we can better wait with this and make sure that we have all the things we already want to be finished, and then move on with the Node project when we are ready for it. And that might be in 1 or 2 years. We will see. Oh, well, that's more. So I'm also doing something else. I went to Los Angeles, and I went to talk to people in the film business. I was invited by AMD to meet with film producers, film investors, and all the other stuff, because we also want to be an animation studio. And the Blender Institute is not only about getting Blender better, making the Blender cloud, and supporting lots of developers. I want that to be combined with making and using Blender. And I think it's a fantastic opportunity if we can grow this institute to be a bigger company where we make film, commercial, but in a complete open source pipeline. So that is what I've been pitching in the past weeks in Los Angeles with fantastic contacts. And we will continue this and we'll go back to LA in 2 or 3 months, hopefully and expected with a finished barbershop. That's a 2.5, 3 minute almost test with the secret agent. And most of that is possible thanks to the cloud subscribers. Thank you, guys. Yeah. So, to close it, almost in time. I don't have a badge. I'm violating my own rules. But yes, please keep your badge and keep it here. No creative things like putting it in your back pocket and stuff. Because the badge is also meant to be some kind of a identification that you know that the people who walk around here are actually meant to be here. So you can put your bag or your phone or something there without it getting stolen or whatever. But it's important that you know you are here because you are part of the conference. Every day is lunch. You can find that upstairs if you go in the cafe. Lunch will be served. You take whatever you like. And the speakers, we have, as you can see, a bit of better streaming and of camera work. There's wireless. We prefer not to have those desks with people standing free for audiences. That means that we have to rig up people a bit better. But we all have assistants, and they are here, including Francesco, who just left to do something else. But we also have Helen, there's Helen. She will be walking around. Contact me, Helen or Francisco, if you are a speaker and you need assistant. And of course, you can talk to them for it. So tonight, there are 2 screenings for the festival. They're both identical, so you don't think you have to go to both. Just pick one, the early one, and then go for food after. It's about 1 hour. Or take the late one. Usually, the second one is more quiet even, so I would advise you, if you want to see it, to go at 9:30. On Saturday, we have a lighting talks, open stage. That is a moment when anyone, everyone is invited to come on here and have a 5-minute talk about what you do, show your art, show what you're coding, show whatever it is, for as long as it's Blender related. You have to make an appointment to get on the list with Olivier. Is here Olivier? Ah, that's Olivier. Olivier is the guy who's handling the lighting talks. Talk to him and make sure that you get listed and then we make a fantastic event tomorrow about it. There's also a meeting room available. This is upstairs, also in the cafe. And a lot of people who say, yeah, so we have some thing, and we want to talk about it in a more quiet way. Can we have 1 hour, a place, and we can lock a door and have a meeting with 5, 6, 10, whatever people. All possible. Talk to me or Francesco or one of the body people, and they will show you where it is. So, well, that's the last slide. Thanks to the sponsors, of course. We have this for the did it for the first time, and it's a big success. So that means that this conference is also well funded. We don't make a loss on it anymore. And thanks to our sponsors, we can make this a fabulous conference. So thank you, sponsors. And I wish you all a fantastic conference. Thank you.